Sorry about that, just doing a bit of lockdown air base, as you do. Excuse me. Hope everybody's all right. Hello and welcome back. Quiz again. Quiz number 11. Now, before I start the quiz, I've been thinking about this and I think we'll do four more. We'll do this one and then three more and then we'll give it a rest. I don't know. It depends what happens with lockdown, because what's happening now is a lot more people are going back to work. As you know, all the shops are open and a lot of other stuff. Some people never stop working, a lot of people. And there's football on. There's two matches a day pretty much every night, and I know a lot of people like the quiz also like the football. So I think for a little while we'll give it a bit of a rest. You know, you can have too much of a good thing, and it'll be 14 weeks altogether, which was, you know, damn good run. And it's not cast in stone that it's finished forever. We'll just see what happens. I don't even know what's happening with me. I'm working home at the minute, but we'll see what happens anyway. Anyway, right. I shall give you more updates as I know. At the moment, let's get on with this week's quiz. First off, as traditional, beer. Back to beer this week. And back to the music round as well. So, I said I would put it back in. So there you go. Anyway, we'll start with general knowledge as usual. Some easy ones to start. Number one, felinology is the study of which animal? You should be able to all get that. Felinology is the study of which animal? F-E-L-I-N-O-L-O-G-Y. Felinology. Number two, in which country is the Copperberg Brewery famous for its flavoured ciders? Probably heard of it even if you don't drink it. It's quite nice, Copperberg. The alcohol-free one's very good for anybody drinking alcohol-free. As I know one of the people is on here for charity. Well done. Number three. Mobile, I'm not answering that. It's a text anyway, so they'll have to wait. If it's you out there at this time, 10 to 5 on Thursday, sorry about that, but there we go. Number three. In mathematics, what is the value of pi to two decimal places? In other words, the first three digits of pi. You should know that. We'll all get taught it at school, not that anybody ever uses it when they leave school, at least not anybody I know. Number four. The Beaufort scale is used to measure what? The Beaufort scale is used to measure what? It's B-E-E-U-F-O-R-T. Beaufort. It's used to measure what? That's number four. Number five. Which English inventor is best known for inventing the wind-up radio, the clockwork radio? Early 90s he made that. So which English inventor is best known for inventing the wind-up clockwork radio? Number six, which chemical element is sometimes also called quicksilver? Quicksilver's the old name for it. Which chemical element is sometimes also known as quicksilver? That was number six. Number seven, how many wisdom teeth do most adults eventually grow? How many wisdom teeth do most adults eventually grow? Question came because I'm 50, coming up to 56, and I've got one coming in at the back now. Well, no other buggers there, but language, Timothy. Number, move on. I don't know. Just obviously, this BS very, very good. This Corona. What to number eight? Particularly waffly tonight. Number eight. Which type of pastry is used in a chocolate eclair? If you're making chocolate eclairs, what type of pastry is used? And number nine, which royal was the daughter of Prince Edward, Duke of Kent, and Princess Victoria of Saxe-Coburg-Saalfeld? Who was their offspring? Which royal? Which royal was the daughter of Prince Edward, Duke of Kent, and Princess Victoria of Saxe-Coburg-Saalfeld? So which royal is that? Who was born to them two? Number 10. Here's the three possible answers one. Number 10. On which date did euro coins and banknotes first appear in general circulation? Was it 2000, 2001 or 2002? On which date did euro coin, in which year did euro coins and banknotes first enter general circulation? Was it 2000, 2001 or 2002? Which one of those years did the euro go into circulation? So up to guess the song. Very, very easy one to start. In fact, a lot of easy ones in this round, if I'm honest. Number one, Goodbye Norma Jean, Though I Never Knew You At All. I don't think there's anybody who would get that. Number one, Goodbye Norma Jean, Though I Never Knew You At All. Number two, Baby, If You've Got To Go Away, I Don't Think I Can Take The Pain. Number two, Baby, If You've Got To Go Away, I Don't Think I Can Take The Pain. Number three, Maybe, Maybe It's The Clothes We Wear, The Tasted Bracelets and The Dye In Our Hair. Maybe, Maybe It's The Clothes We Wear, The Tasted Bracelets and The Dye In Our Hair. That's number three. Number four, I'll Protect You From The Hooded Claw, Keep The Vampires From Your Door. Number four again, I'll Protect You From The Hooded Claw, Keep The Vampires From Your Door. And number five, Look Into My Eyes, You Will See What You Mean To Me. Look Into My Eyes, You Will See What You Mean To Me. Number six, Here Comes Johnny Yen Again With The Liquor And Drugs. Here Comes Johnny Yen Again With The Liquor And Drugs. It's number six. Obviously not following lockdown very healthily. Number seven, You Used To Get It In Your Fishnets, Now You Only Get It In Your Nightdress. Number seven, You Used To Get It In Your Fishnets, Now You Only Get It In Your Nightdress. I mainly try to keep it a family show, but not time is a bit of a dark area. Number eight, In France, A Skinny Man Died Of A Big Disease With A Little Name. Number eight again. In France, a skinny man died of a little... Number eight again. In France, a skinny man died of a big disease with a little name. That's number eight. Number nine. I am the lineman for the county and I drive the main road. I am the lineman for the county and I drive the main road. That's number nine, and that's an oldie. I'll tell you that much. Number 10, Don't Start Me Talking, I Could Talk All Night. Number 10 again, Don't Start Me Talking, I Could Talk All Night. Actually, it applies to me, come to think of it, to be honest, that one. And that was the 10 bits of lyrics of music, the opening titles of music. You can play it either way you want. You can play it a point for both the song and the singer, or just the song, or just the singer, whatever you want to do, you know what I mean. You know by now, you've been playing long enough. 11 weeks, most of you. Sport, 10 on sport. Number one, Tessa Sanderson won gold for Team GB in 1984 in which event? I know it's a while ago, but she's very well known. Number one again, Tessa Sanderson won gold for Team GB in 1984 in which event? Number two, which golfing term means scoring three under par? There's like a nickname for it, for scoring three under par. Which golfing term means scoring three under par? That's number two. Number three, the Nationals are an American Major League Baseball team from which US city? The Nationals are an American Major League Baseball team from which US city? Oh, excuse me, there we go. There's the beer starting. That's the beer talking. Number four, which three individual sports are combined to make an Olympic triathlon? Now, I want all three sports or you don't get the point. Simple as. Which three individual sports are combined to make an Olympic triathlon? You have to name all three sports that make up a triathlon event. Number five, George North, N-O-R-T-H. George North is a famous name in which sport? That's number five. George North is a famous name in which sport? Number six, who is the, quite a long one this, who is the only footballer to have scored a goal in an FA Cup final, a League Cup final, a UEFA Cup final and a UEFA Champions League Cup final? Who is the only footballer to have scored a goal in an FA Cup final, a League Cup final, a UEFA Cup final and a UEFA Champions League final? Who's one person has done that? Who is it? Number seven, which horse with a very apt weather-related name won the 2015 Grand National? It is quite apt for the weather at the moment. Which horse with a very apt weather-related name won the 2015 Grand National? And number 8, Grace Road, also known as the Fisher County Ground, is the home ground and administrative base of which county cricket club? Grace Road, aka the Fisher County Road, is the home ground and administrative base of which county cricket club? Number 9, the Minster Men is the nickname of which city's football club? Think about the name and you'll get it. The Minster Men is the nickname of which city's football club? And number 10, the last one of this round, the Bledisloe Cup is contested in which sport? It's spelt B-L-E-D-I-S-L-O-E. Bledisloe. The Bledisloe Cup is contested in which sport? That is number 10. Got to be time for another sip now. Must be. Ah, it's very, very nice. Very nice. TV and film. Easy start again. Probably, I'm not sure that I've had it, but not to worry. It says in as an easy one, so it doesn't really matter. Number 1, how many Back to the Future films were released? How many Back to the Future films were released? Number 2, Tracy Stubbs, Sharon Theodopoulos and Dorian Green are the main characters of which TV comedy show? Number 2 again, Tracy Stubbs, Sharon Theodopoulos and Dorian Green are the main characters of which TV comedy show? Number 3, in which film would you hear the quote, "In every job that must be done, there is an element of fun"? I haven't found that in life, to be honest with you. Most jobs I just simply can't be bothered with, but that's just me, like. Actually, no, there's a few others, like, you know. Start new competition, Bone Idol. Never mind. Number 3 again, in which film would you hear the quote, in every job that must be done, there is an element of fun"? Bone Idol. You can, like, sort of telephone in and vote off the one who actually does the least, and that's an idea. Number 4, Walter Skinner, assistant director of the FBI, was played by Mitch Pileggi in which popular science fiction television show? Walter Skinner, who was assistant director of the FBI, was played by Mitch Pileggi in which popular sci-fi TV show? Number 5, The Dog in the Pond is a pub featured in which UK television soap? The Dog in the Pond is a pub featured in which UK TV soap? And number 6, which 1986 horror film was advertised with the line, "Be afraid, be very afraid"? Which 1986 horror film was advertised with the line, "Be afraid, be very afraid"? And on to number 7, who is the regular presenter of Channel 4's 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown? Who is the regular presenter of Channel 4's 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown? Number 8, in the 1996 film Independence Day, who plays the American president? What is the name of that actor? In the 1996 film Independence Day, who plays the American president? And number 9, the actor Hugh Bonneville is famous for starring in all 6 seasons of which UK television drama series? The actor, called Hugh Bonneville, that's the actor name, is famous for starring in all 6 seasons of which UK TV drama series? And number 10, which soon-to-be-released Disney film is a real action remake of an animated feature? So, basically, you know, there was an animated feature film in the past, all cartoon. It's the most current one to be turned into real-life actors doing that, their version. So which soon-to-be-released Disney film is a real action remake of an animated feature? What's the newest one that's going to be released? Not quite out yet. Would have been, if it hadn't been for lockdown. That is basically the 40 questions and very little stuttering this week. Very little stuttering indeed, which is quite strange. I'll probably make up for it on the answers video, which will follow next. So the answers video I shall film now, and it will be on around about 9:15 or so. So good luck. I hope you're still enjoying it, and I'll see you then. Cheers.